Long before Hetty Wainthrop was a private detective, she was a wife and mother. That's proved to be valuable experience for her current profession. After all, her work often involves the family life of her clients, and she's well attuned to the nuances of relationships between husband and wife, parent and child. Sometimes, too, her clients bring out the mother in her, and she's ever ready with a kind word, some tea and biscuits, and even when necessary, a firm maternal reprimand. Hetty's own son, Derek, has long since moved away from home, far away. He lives with his wife in Australia, where he works in computers. Hetty and her husband, Robert, miss their son, of course, but they take consolation in the presence of Hetty's young assistant, Jeffrey, who lives in Derek's old room. Though Jeffrey is an employee of the Wainthrop Detective Agency, he's also become a member of the Wainthrop family, a second son to Hetty and Robert. Perhaps it's Hetty's maternal instincts that lead her to accept her latest case. Well, that and the promise of a fee. Hetty's client is also a mother who's worried about her daughter, the victim of an apparent stalker. It's clearly difficult for the woman to bring herself to hire a private detective. She comes from a military family which believes in facing one's problems with a stiff upper lip. It's not the done thing to ask for help from strangers, especially when they come in the improbable form of Hetty Wainthrop. But Hetty may well be her client's only hope, for she's not afraid to do battle with those who would threaten this daughter of the regiment.